Today we're here to build a miniature aquaponics system that can be used in the classroom or by the homeowner to be able to teach people how to do aquaculture and hydroponic production, or also be able to grow some food to be able to supplement your grocery bill. So whenever you're in the home improvement store, you're going to be looking at a lot of different types of parts and pieces here. These are both 1/2 inch PVC ball valves, but you can see they're different sizes and they're different colors. So the sort of off-white with the red, that's for CPVC, which is used for a different application. It's more heat rated, and it actually has a different diameter, so it won't fit your standard PVC parts. And this is regular PVC. At this particular store, it has a blue handle, and so that's what we've bought here today. That's what we're going to be working with. That'll push together on the PVC really easily. These are both half inch pipe, but one of them, this is a schedule 40 pipe. You can see much thicker walls, much stronger, can handle a lot more pressure, and this is class pipe. So it's thinner walls, you can get more water volume going through there, but you can't handle the pressure. So this one's more for pressurized, this is for non-pressurized. This one has some structural rigidity, this one's very, very loose and floppy. So depending on your application, we're going to use the Schedule 40 today. Alright, so when you're at the store, make sure that you're looking inside of each one of the bins where the PVC parts are at. These are two of the same exact size parts. But whenever you look at them, this one looks a little different than the other, and that one's got threads on it and this one doesn't. So whenever people are looking through these, they'll tend to throw some back in a different container. You want to make sure that you're picking up the right part. So in our particular application, we're looking for a slip, so that has no threads, and this is a threaded, female threaded side, so we're going to put this one back and we're going to buy this one. This right here is Teflon tape. So what we do with this is we will wrap the threads with this tape. What this is gonna do is gonna keep water from leaking around each of those threads when we tighten it together. Whenever we are gluing stuff together, you wanna use a primer. This purple primer is nice because it kind of shows you where you've gotten to on the piece. So the primer, what it does is it preps the surface of the PVC pipe in order for it to accept the glue, and you get a stronger bond on there. So you want to make sure that you're getting the right primer for the right application. And so PVC is what we're using, so that's what we're going to go with. Keep in mind that these things will dry out and evaporate and congeal on you, so it's usually best, unless you've done a project in the last month or two, probably to get some new stuff. So it's nice to have those in a handy pack where they come together like that. This is our part that we're going to use to connect our hose to our pipe. So there's a nipple on this side, and so that'll insert into our hose, and then this is threaded on this side. So like I said, with the Teflon tape, we're going to wrap the male piece that's going to thread into this female piece. So you'll see that. This is a 90 degree elbow, so for our particular system, we're going to be coming straight up from the bottom, and we want a 90 degree over. There's a couple of different types of vinyl PVC here. The clear one and the black. This opaque tubing is going to prevent algae growth inside there, and you won't, because it's blacked out, you won't be able to see what's going on inside there. In our particular application, we're going to be using this clear vinyl so that we can see the water flow going through there. Also, the black is more of a specialty product for your ponds. And so this clear stuff is going to be a good bit cheaper. So we decided to go with the clear. So for our particular tank, we're using a 55-gallon aquarium, and so we want the water to exchange about 3 times per hour, ideally. And so, you know, if we have a 55-gallon aquarium, you know, 155 gallons an hour seems about right. This pump uses a lot less electricity than this pump, but you need to look a little bit closer. This particular pump is made for 2 to 3 foot of pumping height, where this pump is made for about 3 to 5 foot of pumping height. And so as your water, the height of the water you're trying to pump changes, you're going to need more capacity to be able to push that water. So in this particular application, we're going to choose this pump, the larger pump, not the smaller pump, because the larger pump is going to provide the water that we want at the height of water that we're trying to pump to. We're looking at a larger size gravel. You know, this is going to be a little bit large on the plant roots, and they could grow in here But what you're not getting is quite as much surface area for bacterial attachment and for water to attach to the outsides of those rocks. When we look here, this is the pea gravel that we chose. It has a lot more surface area per volume of material that you're going to be using, and so we can hold more water and more bacteria can attach to that. But it still has enough pore space here for the water to drain out of it really easily. If we look here at sand, of course sand is very small diameter and you'll be able to get a lot of surface area there, but because it's so small, the water won't flow through it very easily, so we opt not to use sand in this particular application. Whenever you're choosing the pipes that you want to use to hold back the pea gravel, you have some choices when you go to the store. And so all of these three are the same diameter of the corrugated piping, but they're all different. If you look at this pipe, it doesn't have any holes in it. The corrugations are going to give it structural stability, but it's made for letting water move through it, but no water to get through the sidewalls of the pipe. If you look at this particular pipe, this one's made to handle large volumes of water coming from the side, but those holes are going to be so large that your pea gravel can actually go through it. What we want is something a little bit sort of in between, and so these slots are going to allow the water to drain through, but it's not going to allow the gravel to fall through there. So we chose to use that style. When we're looking at lights, it's also important to keep in mind what the plants want for photo spectrum. So we're looking here at the different colors of light. So 2700 Kelvin is going to be around in kind of the orangey red spectrum. As we get a little bit warm, cooler as they call it, the number temperature Kelvin is going to go up, and so also we're looking at the efficiency of this particular light, the number of lumens that you get per watts. So this is a 48 watts in this one. Your light output is 3,800 lumens, and so the number of lumens per watt or efficiency is 79.17. So that's going to be better than something like an incandescent bulb. So overall with this system, we spent under $250 for all of the materials here. We spent about $70 on the aquarium,